Is data analytics dead? Thousands of early care professionals are asking whether data analytics a good career option. But the real question they should ask is data analytics career dying? Especially with rise of machines and most importantly with generative artificial intelligence. And if it is so, what should we do about that? Stay with me till the end. In this episode, I will systematically explain why is the fear in first place, what is actually happening, and three steps to follow to be ready for the future.
Like, share, subscribe Data Bicep.
Hello friends, welcome to another episode of Data Bicep. This is almost 80% reshoot of one of my earlier videos, but I had to take that down because of some technical glitches, but had got such good response that I thought of shooting it again. I hope you will enjoy this. Few months back, I came across an article by Forbes which asked a question that whether ChatGPT is a threat to data analysts in 2023. And since then, I was thinking of making an episode solely on it to understand how serious the situation is. And few weeks back, I saw a similar post from IBM. Hence, better late than never, it's time to understand what is changing in the industry. So when I searched this on Google, I got approximately 60 million questions and suggestions around that. It overwhelmed me, and I think it will overwhelm you as well, depending on the career stage you are in. So if the question is, do you need to be afraid? Answer is both yes and no. Let's try to understand it in a very structured way. One of the most common management consultant framework to understand a situation is to ask systematically why, what, and how. We will follow the same approach and ask three questions. Why is the fear in first place? What is actually happening? And how should we be ready for that in future? But before I start digging deep, can you answer two questions? At what stage of your career you are in? And what is your biggest fear? Here, I am taking 3-second pause. Please type your answer in the comment section. Are you done? Then let's go back to the original question. The first question was, why is the fear in first place? Last few years, generative AI got high traction and large language model became point of interest for many researchers. Only towards end of last year, ChatGPT came to existence. But since then, many other LLM applications emerged in just a matter of months. No doubt, it's one of kind general purpose AI that has potential to eradicate many manual processes, but that doesn't mean anyone who works in analytical role today is going to be out of job by tomorrow. This is primarily because today, even most sophisticated LLM and NLP tools still lack abilities like critical thinking, strategic planning, complex problem solving, and etc. But just think, if an Alexa or Google Assistant-like application can answer a CEO's question about financial results, sales direction, competition structure, why would he hire an analyst to produce the same result at higher cost? Since that's the long-term promise of AI, many people entering workforce today are assuming that it's going to take their job. Maybe so, to some extent, it will in the future, but no one knows that for sure. We are working on a video to compile a list of jobs that might be addressed. Please watch out for that in coming weeks. But while I said that, it's proven many times in history that many of such projections have not gone right. Here is the catch. If you are an aspiring analyst or maybe just a few years in the job, you need to ask next question very diligently. And that is, what is actually changing for data analysts? For this, let's understand what does a data analyst do. A data analyst will pull data, clean and prepare it for analysis, maybe for a sales report, put it in Excel or Google Sheet, create pivot table or maybe run few functions on it, make dashboard using either Excel, Tableau, Power BI or any visualization tool, investigate problems, do critical thinking, identify opportunities of improvement, and provide the findings and present that to management with a very strong point of view. If you look closely, AI is trying to take a lot of manual work out. AI is automating the process from top to bottom, whereas business wants a data analyst to spend more time on bottom four steps because the true value is on those steps. Hence, if you already have just started your journey of data analytics or already spent few years in it, it's important that you ask the next questions, which is most relevant for you. How can I be ready for the future in the changing world of data? Generative AI still needs some time to become mainstream, and at the same time, it has to overcome few other hurdles as well, which are not always technical, but sometimes socio-political as well. One thing we can safely say that data analyst role are not going away just like that by tomorrow. So don't be too scared, especially if you're already in the journey of becoming a data analyst. There is still a huge demand for you. But you should definitely do three things. First, accept. AI or augmented AI in workplace is the future. You cannot stick your head in the sand and think that AI is not coming, because AI will get sophisticated over a period of time and will be capable of doing more tasks. More you accept the fact, it will help you to prepare yourself to work with the change, not against it. Secondly, learn to use AI tool, ChatGPT, Bard, Copilot, etc. Few months back, there was just ChatGPT, but now there are hundreds of tools that can use large language model. Best you learn how to use ChatGPT, or for that matter, any of such tools that comes in future. Few things you can do using AI, such as search efficiently, generate data structure, generate error-free code blocks, get ideas to use graphs, charts, numbers to design compelling stories, create dummy data, create training materials, automate testing or test cases, identify best practices, and many more. Ultimately, learn to make AI work for you, not other way around. Lastly, utilize the lead time that you have and don't stop learning. Now tell me, what do you think about the future? Please comment that below. If you like the video, please give us a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to Data Bicep for more such videos. We will meet again next week. Bye.